I've weighed it.
Now it is almost got to the annoying bit. That's what I normally do. This isn't doing it first. Because. Help. Because.
Oh, pull him at the angle for
what date is it?
3rd of June.
Apparently, what's my open block 1524?
Push dash 430.
Days that I thought would never end. I've seen all the times when I could not find. finisher for those non-stop oldies. Just ahead of Sally's track.
Here's
what's happening in the news. David Cameron is dispatched for tomorrow, Friday, with police in Cumbria, where shootings left 12 people dead and 11 injured. The PM sympathised with communities left deeply torn by Wednesday's horrific events, but warned against knee-jerk changes to gun laws. The number of passengers British Airways carried in May fell by 14.2% from a year ago as the impact of cabin crew strikes hit the airline. I think it's the last day of the current strike today. Isn't it, Sal? Last day today?
Yes, until the next one.
Yeah. Okay. Tens of thousands of airline passengers in the UK are still waiting for reimbursement after their flights were delayed by volcanic ash in April. Under EU rules, European airlines must pick up the bill for their passengers' hotel and food bills while stranded. The Air Transport Users Council said most airlines appear to have huge backlogs of claims to process. But, you know, they're pretty good at collecting the fares. Just one click and they've got the fare. But, you know, when they're getting back, it's a bit slower, don't you think? This is Steve Wright in the afternoon. A bit so instant, but... See what I'm saying?
Yes.
You can pass that experience.
No.
But east of Kilmarnock, the A71 is blocked both ways. And south of there, the A77 is blocked at Nabon. They're both for accidents at both places. Take care on the M8. Now, as you head towards Edinburgh on the M8, apparently a herd of cows escaped from a field, and they all went on to the M8, affecting the stretch between 3 and 2, Livingston and Newbridge. I don't know if they've all been rounded up yet. But if you're slow on that bit of the M8, as I said, that is the reason why. Oslo Whistle, the 8M75, Junction 4, west of the town is overturned. According to Big Gap, there's a 2-mile queue on the...
She's talking while I'm puffing.
That's A50. Well, the Mere Tunnel has finally reopened eastbound, but because there were quite a few breakdowns in the tailback that formed, traffic still very slow on the eastbound approaches to it. Off junction 13 of the M1, so east of it, the A507 in Bedfordshire is blocked both ways at Millbrook following an accident. There was an accident on the M1 between 13 and 12, which came and went quite quickly, but it's still being a little bit on the slow side because we've got roadworks there. A lot of people get off and have diverted down the A5, so that's quite busy through the Dunstable area. M25 clockwise, one lane block 27 to 28, queues from 26 has a breakdown there. The queues.
It's a horrible angle again, I'm afraid. Three of the year. But I'm going to ask for a refund because, according to my scales, it weighs 3.6 kilos.
Please. Just
Yeah, right.
Is it one of the songs? Oh.
the song, you know.
Why not wear some shirts too tight? That's a nice goose.
Sound repackaged it, and rather than being sort of a nice little success in terms of those who had first
watched the album,
could have been 70 seasons and perhaps beyond that, but not that far beyond.
Yeah,
it turned out to be in the top 10 of the UK album charts for 10 or 11 weeks, and had it not run out of stock 2 weeks in a row, it was fighting for the number one slot with James Blunt and Coldplay.
Wow.
And by the end of the year, it sold another 600,000 albums, one of the best-selling albums of the year. Surprised everyone.
How did the album come about in the first place? Remind us of how all that occurred in the 70s.
During the period of the War of the Worlds, I had just finished being David Essex's producer and arranger, and I toured with David as his MD for the first 2 years of his touring. And my dad reminded me one day, he said, look, you're a composer and you've always said you want to try to develop two or three major works interpreting a story from whatever genre that you fall in love with and that you can interpret in your own particular way. And just as I was going out on one of these tours with David, my dad handed me H.G. Wells's The War of the Worlds. And as you do when you're touring, there's a lot of traveling time and all that, and I started reading it and discovered it was nothing like what I thought The War of the Worlds was going to be, because all I remember was a little boy in New York growing up, sometime on sort of daytime TV, you'd get this movie War of the Worlds, and it was set in contemporary America. The storylines were all based around characters and plots that had to do with society in that period. And here I'm reading a Victorian tale that had nothing to do with what I thought it was, but I really fell in love with it, and it was immediately in my mind that I could hear sound and develop ideas from it.
And you were never tempted to make it a modern day thing. You wanted always to keep it in Victorian time.
Absolutely, Tim, because to me what I discovered was that here was Victorian humanity being invaded by an alien force. And what did we have in Victorian times? We had rifles and cannons. And to defend ourselves against this invading force that not only were superior in intelligence, but had incredible machines and weaponry, it wasn't a fair fight. So that's more terrifying than, say, in today's world where you'd think we'd have a chance of defending ourselves. But I also discovered H.G. Wells...
No! Not again!
...tentacles, and the tentacles were really an analogy for nations that were conquering others.
Yeah,
the tentacles of power. And we were, of course, with the British Empire, behind expansionism. And I like that. He wasn't trying to knock us over the head with preaching to us, but he was taking a view through his story of fantasy and when he was reading, of course.
Now, the War of the Worlds stage show dates are Thursday, 2nd of December, Newcastle Arena. Friday, the 3rd of December, Glasgow SECC, Sheffield Arena, then, this is 4th of December, then on to, by the 5th, we're at Manchester MENA, and then we're at Liverpool, Nottingham, Birmingham, Bournemouth, London O2, maybe on the 12th, Cardiff, Brighton Centre, Wembley Arena, right up until Saturday the 18th of December, these are December dates. Now, you're working on this new show because what do? You kind of upgrade, update, change it?
Absolutely. To me, it's a living work. At the end of each production, if we've been fortunate to be invited back again or to new countries, as we are playing on this next tour as well as the UK, I go back to our storyboard and just see what is it that might come out in a visual way or a sound way, or all different technologies that we can bring to the piece. And there's always something that excites us, and we start with a wish list, and eventually we bring it down to the things that will have the most impact. And this next tour is going to have a dramatic amount of new ingredients that the last one didn't, and the last one had things that the previous one
space for,
and so on.
Would you ever do, like they've done a follow-up to Phantom, is there a War of the Worlds 2, or are you just happy with upgrading and updating?
Well, the arena tour is its own life, so to speak, but I've never seen a sequel in the sense of continuing the story on. I think it's so concise. I like to find something new that challenges me creatively.
Yeah.
But what we have now been approached to do, and I'm starting to warm very heavily to the idea, is like a new generation, whereby I re-record it using the technology of today, and with guest artists that are hopefully as talented as the people that I worked with originally. And
that's
it's
a great idea.
It's fairly advanced now in the discussions as well, but until, you know, it's 100% sure. And I wouldn't start until after I complete this next tour, so it's getting close, though, I must say.
Patrick Stewart do the voice?
I can't say, because I don't know is the truth.
Well,
he's got a super voice.
Do you want us to audition for the,
Impressionist last night, be good.
Jeff Wayne is conducting War of the Worlds on his European tour, which begins in November and reaches the UK at the start of December. Thank you very much, Jeff. We'll see you next time.
Steve, thank you, and Bertin, lovely to see you.
Over here and I. Buzz for me. What are you?
Fabulous. Love it. 7-4. This is Radio City.
It's a bit weak if you ask me.
Baby Ashley, it's thanks to her also that I can listen to your whole show on my Freeview TV instead of sitting outside in the car. I think I've swung around to Radio 2 now. I hope so. Love the show and the chat, especially the Factoids. All the best.
Yes, nice to see you from Sam.
This is Sally from Radio 2. What you got?
That's progress for you.
Holden Hill near Exeter. I think just by the race course, an accident southbound has left it partly blocked. M3 reports of a breakdown northbound between Fleet Services and Junction 4A. One lane is blocked. M25, a miserable day again on the M25 clockwise. One lane is blocked between 27 and 28, the M11 and A12. Due to a breakdown, it must be a complicated one because it's been there for ages. The queue is awful. It's stationary all the way around from Junction 24. There are queues both sides of the dark for crossing. The anti-clockwise queue that up to the tunnel is queuing from Junction 3. And clockwise 16 to 19, the M40 through the roadworks very slow. But there was an accident between 21 and 22 clockwise which blocked two lanes. It's unclear at the moment as whether it's still there or not, but it is slow, as I say, clockwise through the roadworks. Off a junction 13 of the M1, the 507 is blocked at Millbrook in Bedfordshire. M6 northbound junction 12, there was an accident, it's on the side, but we've got queues from junction 11 and queues 2 or 3 miles southbound as a corner. The M65 finally westbound junction forward, Ottawa Whistle, caravans overturned.
Yes, finally.
There's a long queue as a consequence, including the 6119 coming out of Blackburn. Very busy indeed. That's it. Ooh, more in half an hour.
Thanks, Al.
Yeah.
thing. I'm only hoping your arms recover. Never yet. Bye. Bedroom. Scales. Oh. Ow! Scales. Just to reconfirm. That's gone up. 3.7. That's making go up. 3.7! Dust. And me, I weigh 79.1.